Welcome. I am Kuthumi and I come upon the Platinum Ray of Wisdom and Silence. First, I would like to explain about frequencies. Every energy has a frequency. Your body is energy, so it has a certain frequency. The earth and everything around you has a frequency, the animals, the plants, your food, and yes, even the car you drive. Now, what is this frequency? Imagine it is snowing. At first, the snow is coming down slow, at a low speed or frequency. Then the snow starts coming down faster, a higher speed or frequency. This is happening to your planet Earth, but also to your physical and spiritual bodies. Have you ever noticed that there are certain people you understand and some you do not have any idea of what they are saying? This is also because of the frequencies. You are able to understand people that are at a lower frequency, but they might annoy you a little bit. People that are in higher frequency are making less sense to you, which might be a bit annoying as well, or you might even feel fear or anger. The consciousness around the planet has frequencies as well. You can see this as layers or dimensions. Every time you reach a certain frequency, you are able to tap into a new level of consciousness. Why are we putting so much emphasis on this right now? New levels of consciousness have been opened. This means that more and more of the veil that is around your planet has been dissolved. So you are able to reach higher frequencies of consciousness. What this means is that you are able to consciously access more information when your physical and spiritual body go into a higher frequency. The conscious knowing is dependent upon how much you have integrated or are connected to your spiritual self and how high your frequency is. Many of the new teachings have a higher frequency than the older teachings. This is because they are coming from higher consciousness than before. The people that are bringing out these teachings have raised their frequencies enough to be able to tap into this higher frequency consciousness. This also gives the opportunity for many of you to raise your own frequencies to this higher consciousness. These new teachings are not just based upon reaching those higher frequencies, but they are also focused on maintaining and becoming consciously aware of this higher consciousness. Many people have not been able to understand the new frequency teachings and are sometimes a little bit afraid to take the next step. There are also people who say, "I can do this by myself." And yes, you can. Teachings are there mostly to support you and make you go faster if needed, but this is entirely your choice. And is part of your right to make decisions and choices based upon what you feel is right for you. We do, however, would like for you to have a choice. And think about it before you make decisions that might be based upon fear or anything else that might stand in your way. There are people who say that they don't need support or teachers. And again, this is true. Everything is available, but are you able to grasp it, understand it, and be consciously aware of it? This message has been channeled to you in a higher frequency, and some will say they completely understand, others might not. There is nothing wrong here. We do, however, notice a lot of angst or fear among many people of not getting there, not being able to consciously grasp what is happening. And you do have to ask yourself what is holding you back at this point. You have set your intent, you feel you have done or are doing everything that is needed. What is needed is stepping out of the normal process that has been taught all these years, holding on to older teachings. You accept the new energies that are coming in, but they are more of a support system. They do help in bringing your physical and spiritual bodies into a higher frequency. But all this is lost when there is no conscious awakening or remembering of all that is happening. When you are not able to consciously experience, then you can have the highest frequency of all, but this doesn't help in the process toward ascension. Yes, you heard me right this time, and many of you know me for being straightforward with my messages lately, and I intend to continue this. Some people consider this not loving, not the ascended master's way, or think the masters are beyond any ego or duality. So why do I find some of this in their messages? This is not possibly coming from an ascended master. We are beyond duality and ego, and we come from unity and love. But the people upon planet Earth are still living in this consciousness. I don't mind putting in the lyrical words that stroke your egos and make you feel better. But at one point we need to go beyond that. We need to look beyond ego and duality and look at the truth of what is happening. You have entered the golden age of conscious awakening. What are you going to do with this? It is almost 2008, which means only about 4 more years for your planet to get ready to move into the fifth dimension. This is going to happen no matter how many people are fighting against it or are working with the planet. Let me tell you how I see it. At this point in time, the 24 ancients have incarnated in the physical on your planet. Many of the ascended masters and other high-frequency beings have incarnated on your planet. The 24 ancient ones are now coming to complete conscious awakening and are not just tapping into the consciousness around your planet. They are able to go directly to source and are bringing in the new teachings. This is their main focus right now. We will explain more about these 24 ancient beings later. For now, this is what you need to know about them. The 24 ancient ones have several tasks ahead of them. One of their final tasks will be assisting your planet into the fifth dimension. This process will start in the year 2010. I would also like to address the story about the year 2007 and 2008 being the year of the ascension of your planet. In part, this is true. Your planet has ascended into a completely new frequency. The frequency of the golden ray. In the year 2010, your planet will move into the frequency of the platinum ray. This is happening regardless of how many people are ready. The ascension of your planet Earth is a different, although similar, process as the ascension of all the people upon your planet. But the time frame of the people is separate from that of planet Earth. We know there will be many that will choose to ascend along with your planet. But this is not a prerogative. Yes, we would like to see as many people as possible ascending even before the planet Earth. And we know there is already a group that will be ascending in or before 2010, and among this group will be the 144,000 everyone is talking about. And you all know that there is no such thing as left behind, so as always, it's your choice, your work, your decision. That is also why I wanted to make it clear that the Earth itself is not dependent upon your process. The only thing your process will influence is that of the other people upon your planet. If you are standing still, the people around you are being influenced by that. If you are spreading more and more light, a higher frequency of light, the people around you will feel the influence of that. It might just give them that little boost they need to start their own process. If you think this is leaving you with the responsibility, then remember, you choose. No matter what you chose, it is perfect for you and everyone around you. We do know that many of you have this feeling, this need to help others awaken. This is what you chose to do before coming to planet Earth. So when you make a choice from soul level and not human level. Forget the human part for a while, as it is influenced by third dimensional circumstances, ideas and beliefs. Yes, I know. How do you connect to your soul is the next question. Let me give you a short meditation to start this process. Connecting with your soul. What follows is a meditation that can help you in connecting with your soul. Sit down in a comfortable seat, burn a candle if you like, and relax. Close your eyes and take a few deep breaths. Imagine you are walking in a beautiful place. Anywhere you like, the mountains, on the beach, in the woods. This is your own world. When you walk, have a look around and suddenly you will see a spaceship of light. It lands right in front of you and the door opens. Someone is standing in the doorway asking you to come in. Enter the ship of light and let it take you to an even more beautiful place. When the ship lands again, you open the door and step out. You see a path in front of you, and on this path is a being of light. It is walking toward you, and you know this is a part of you, your soul. Your soul is standing in front of you and is asking you to come with him or her. Together you walk along the path. This is you, the real you, and when you look at your soul, you see yourself. There is a light coming from your soul that is entering through your crown chakra and filling up your entire body. You are merging with your soul, becoming one being of light. You can ask questions if you like, or just stay in the energy of being connected with your soul. Then it is time to leave, knowing that your soul is there, and you are connected no matter what. You are returning to the ship of light. It will take you back to your own world. Just sit in the ship, let yourself remember who you really are. The ship of light lands in your own beautiful place and you leave through the door and you step back into this world. Just sit there for a little bit in your own world before you come fully back into this world. Remember the connection you felt with your souls, how your energies became one. And know that connection is still there. When you are ready, take a deep breath and open your eyes. If you like, you can write down everything that happened. If you feel nothing happened, do not worry. We all have different experiences and ways of experiencing. The connection is there always. You can do this meditation as many times as you like, and you will find out the connection will become stronger and you will start getting answers even when you are not meditating. So on to my next advice. If your choice is to help in assisting others, your own process needs to be in full flight. Keep an eye out for the new teachings. Start feeling the energy coming with these new teachings. You might not completely understand them at this point. I have explained about that in the beginning of my message. Take the next step and let these new energies that have been let loose on your planet assist, support and teach you while you jump with your eyes closed in the deepest part of the pool. Remembering the conscious awakening of your human being completely connected with your spiritual being, fully open and consciously aware of all that is.